So welcome student in our today's section of subject hydraulic power engineering and refrigeration. So today we are going to see the another numerical of the heat balance sheet, and then we will see the catalytic converter. Okay, so here we are going to see this numerical of heat balance sheet. So let's start by reading this numerical. So they provided us the information in this numerical so that the following observations were made during the test of an oil engine. Brake power of engine is 31.5 kilowatt. Here you can see this brake power, we note down here, brake power of engine is 31.5 kilowatt. Fuel use is 10.5 kg per hour. So here mass of fuel is 10.5 kg per hour. We convert it into the minute scale by dividing it by 60. So we divide it by 60 to convert this hour to the minute ratio, per hour to per minute. Then they provided us the calorific value of fuel is 43,000 kilojoule per kg. So C of V is 43,000. We note down it in the given data. Then jacket circulating water here, which is 540 kg per hour. So M of W is 540 kg per hour. We divide it by 60 to get this in the format of kg per minute. Okay. Then here rise in temperature of cooling water is 56 degrees. So here delta T of W is 56. Water circulating through exhaust gas calorimeter is 545 kg per hour. So what is this water circulated through exhaust calorimeter? Okay, then here the rise in temperature of water passing through the exhaust calorimeter is 36 degree. So we note down this. Here delta T of G is 36 degree centigrade. Temperature of exhaust gas leaving the calorimeter is 82 degree centigrade. So we note down this value here. Temperature T of G is 82 degree centigrade. Okay. Then air to fuel ratio is 19.1. So we note down this air to fuel ratio 19.1. Then ambient temperature is 17 degree centigrade. Where the T of A ambient is 17 degree centigrade, and Cp of exhaust gas is 1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So this is Cp of gas is 1 kilojoule per kg here. We already note down this given data, which is they mentioned in our numerical. Now we are going to solve this numerical. So first we are going to calculate the heat supplied by the fuel, and you know the formula for heat supplied, which is M of F into Cv. Value of mass of fuel supplied is 10.5 upon 60 kg per minute into calorific value is 43,000. So we get this value as 7525 kilojoule per minute. Now we are going to calculate the heat spent or utilized heat. So first is heat equivalent to brake power. They provided us heat power in brake power in the form of the kilowatt. So we need to convert it into minute format. So we multiply it by 60. So that so we get this heat equivalent to brake power is 1890 kilojoule per minute. Normally, what we are going to do in this step, we are just converting this brake power, which is in the format of kilojoule per second or watt. So we converting it into kilojoule per minute format by multiplying it by 60. So second is heat rejected to the cooling water. We are going to calculate this, and the formula for this Q of W is equals to M of W into Cp of W into delta T of W. By putting this values which they already mentioned inside the numerical, we get the value of Q of W as 2110.248 kilojoule per minute. Then thirdly, we are going to calculate the heat loss to the exhaust gas. So to calculate this heat loss to the exhaust gas, we need to calculate the mass of the exhaust gas. So to calculate this mass of exhaust gas, we are going to use this relation of the mass of exhaust gas along with the mass of the fuel with the air fuel ratio. So we are having this formula as mass of exhaust gas is equals to m of f is equals to m of f plus air to fuel ratio plus 1. So m of exhaust gas is equals to 10.5 by 60 into 19 plus 1. Air to fuel ratio is 19. So a mass of exhaust gas becomes 3.5 kilojoule per minute here. Okay. So heat loss to the exhaust gas Q of G is equals to M of G into Cp of G into T of G minus T of A. So we put the values here. Mass of exhaust gas is 3.5. We calculated it into 1 into 82 minus 17, and we get the value as 227.5 kilojoule per minute. So this is the again they are providing us that there is a presence of calorimeter. So we need to calculate the heat loss in the calorimeter, which we does not calculate in the previous numerical, but here they provided us the data related to the calorimeter. So we need to calculate the heat lost or heat spent inside the calorimeter, and so formula for this is M of W into Cp of W into delta T of G. By putting this value, we get this value of heat lost in the exhaust gas calorimeter as 1356.149 kilojoule per minute. Now we are going to calculate this unaccounted heat. This unaccounted heat is we calculate the same heat in the previous numerical also. So the formula for unaccounted heat is equals to heat supplied minus summation of the heat spent here. So here heat supplied minus heat equivalent to brake power plus heat rejected due to jacket cooling plus heat loss due to the exhaust gas plus heat loss due to exhaust gas in the calorimeter. So in equation format, it is equals to Q unaccountable heat QU is equals to Q of S minus Q of BP plus Q of W plus Q of G plus Q of GC. So by putting these values here in the calculator, you get the value of unaccountable heat as 1941.103 kilojoule per minute. Now we are going to draw the table of this for this heat balance sheet. This table is quite similar to the previous numerical heat balance sheet, where heat supplied is listed on this left hand side corner, and this heat equivalent to brake power is listed B here in the middle. Then we are going to balance between the heat supplied and heat utilized here. Okay, so you we already calculated that heat supplied by the exhaust by the fuel is 7525. And here heat equivalent to the brake power is 1890. Then heat rejected to the cooling water is 2110.24. Then heat loss to the exhaust gas is 227.5. We convert it into the form of the percentage per heat supply. So to make this percentage, we divide this 1895 by 7525 and multiply it by 100, and we get this value as 25.11. Similarly, here also to get this in the percentage format, we are going to divide this 2110 by 7525, you can see here, and multiply it by 100 to get this value in the form of the percentage of the supply heat. So we get these values as 24.11, then 28.04, then 3.023, then 18.02, and in the last, this unaccountable heat is 25.79 percentage. And if we take the summation of all these values, we get it the as 100%. In practically, you may get the values such as 99.98% or 99.98%, but in the round figure, you can write it as a 100% here. So here you can see the 100% heat supplied is 100% utilized here. So we balance the heat supplied to the heat utilize. Again, if you take summation of this 5, then you get the value as 7525, which is equals to the heat supply. At the end of this numerical, you need to draw this draw this heat balance sheet in the solution here, and your numerical will be ends here. Okay, so here the numericals related to the heat balance sheets are ended. Now we are going to see the calorimeter catalytic converters here. Okay, Now we are going to see this catalytic converter. There are two types of catalytic converter. Two-way catalytic converter and the three-way catalytic converter. So the what is the main function of this catalytic converter? We are going to see today. Okay. So the main purpose of the use of catalytic converter is used to convert the exhaust emission system is to convert the harmful pollutant to harmless gases such as NOx, hydrocarbon and CO present in the exhaust gases. All these are treated in catalyst. So main function of this catalytic converter is to convert the harmful pollutant into the harmless gases. So this nitrogen oxide or hydrocarbon and this carbon monoxide, we need to convert this into the harmless gases because these pollutants can harm the environment. So it is not beneficial for us to leave the environment from this IC engine. So we treat them and convert them into the harmless gases in this catalytic converter. Okay. So main purpose of this catalytic converter is to convert the pollutant into non-harmful gases or harmless gases. So here are converters producing compound gases such as CO2, H2 and N2 which can be safely released in the atmosphere which is non-toxic to the environment. Here rhodium is used as a reducing catalyst for the converting of the NOx nitrogen oxide in the exhaust has to into the nitrogen and oxygen. Then rhodium, then the platinum and palladium are used as an oxidation catalyst which changes these hydrocarbons and carbon monoxide into water and CO2. Look student, this carbon monoxide is harmful as compared to the carbon dioxide. So we are making the oxidation of this carbon monoxide into CO2 which is non-toxic to the environment, and this hydrocarbon into the H2O. Okay. So there are two types of catalytic converter. A two-way catalytic converter which is used to control only CO, carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons emissions by oxidation. A three-way converter which converts the carbon monoxide, CO can be read as the carbon monoxide and hydrocarbon by oxidization as well as NOx by reduction. In three-way catalytic converter, there is oxidation also. Reduction can be possible, but in case of the two-way converter, only oxidation is possible. So here we are going to see this two-way catalytic converter. A catalytic converter consists of a cylindrical unit of small size, like small silencer. It is installed into the exhaust system of vehicles such as scooter, moped, motorcycle, car, or auto rickshaw. So it is connected to the exhaust system of these vehicles. So it is placed between the exhaust manifold and the silencer. Inside the cylindrical tube converters, there is a honeycomb structure of ceramics or metal, which will be coated with the alumina base material, and therefore a second coating of precious metal like platinum, palladium is present there. And this catalytic converter consists of a cylindrical unit, small size like small silencer is installed into the exhaust system of vehicles such as scooter, moped or motorcycle, car or auto rickshaw. Again, we are going to see this point. Inside this cylinder tube converter, there is a honeycomb structure of a ceramic or metal, which will be coated with aluminum based material, and thereafter a second coating of precious metal like platinum, palladium or rhodium or a combination of the same. So this coating serves as a catalyst. So there are the two coating, first coating and the second coating, where the second coating is of the precious metals like platinum, palladium or rhodium, which serves as a catalyst to convert this harmful pollutant into the harmless gases. So here you can see it is the simple diagram of this two-way catalytic converter, where you can see inside this, you can see this is the honeycomb like structure where the second coating of precious metal is provided. So this is the exhaust gases coming from the engine, and when these gases move through this portion, it get converted into the harmless gases, or you may say the clean gases. A catalyst is a substance which causes a chemical reaction that normally does not happen in the given condition. When the exhaust gases passes over the converter substance, the exhaust gases such as carbon monoxide, hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides are converted into the harmless gases such as carbon dioxide, hydrogen and nitrogen here. Now we are going to see this three-way catalytic converter. The main function of this three-way catalytic converter is same as that of the two-way catalytic converter, which is to convert this harmful pollutant into the harmless gases. But here the reduction can also be possible in case of the three-way catalytic converter. Okay, so three-way catalytic converter, this is installed in the exhaust line between the manifold and the muffler. The converter has a mesh or honeycomb metal construction inside. The catalyst is coated on the mesh of the honeycomb. It is commonly used in the petrol engine. So here you can see, this is the three-way catalytic converter. This is the exhaust gas coming in and through this air chamber. It is passing over this honeycomb structure, and we get the clean exhaust gas outside. There are the two stages, first stage converter and the second stage of the converter. We are going to study it in deep further. Okay. So the exhaust gases enter from one side, and the first stage where NOx reduced by rhodium into N2 and O2, and in the second stage platinum or palladium converts this hydrocarbon and CO into the water and CO2. So here in the first stage, what will happen? This rhodium converts this nitrogen oxides into N2 and O2, and in the second stage this platinum or palladium is present, which converts this hydrocarbon and carbon monoxide into the carbon dioxide and CO2. So after the first stage, air from the air pump is supplied with the exhaust gas. The oxygen from air mixes with the hydrocarbon and carbon monoxide presence in the exhaust gas, thus water and CO2 are formed there. The nitrogen, water and the carbon dioxide produces are harmless and released into the atmosphere through other air. Okay, this converter is most efficient when the engine is operating with the stoichiometric air fuel ratio, which is 14:1, and depends on the catalyst used there. The vehicle which are fitted with the catalytic converter must use only unleaded gasoline. If the gasoline contains lead, then lead coal, the catalyst and converter will not work here. So while using this, we should remain in mind that this gasoline must not be used as the fuel, because if the gasoline is present inside the fuel, then it will lead coal, and because of this coal, then the catalytic converter may not be work. Okay, so here our chapter number 2 ends. From to next section, we are going to start this chapter number 3. Okay, if you have any doubts, then you can contact me on my personal WhatsApp number, and we are stopping here. Thank you. Thanks for the today's section. Ah, but don't you?